Hi friends, good morning. Yesterday I have recorded one video lecture, but due to my mistake, I could not produce to you because it was deleted. So today I am continuing that video. So myself AG sir from Sambhir School. Today we are going to discuss about the limitation of valence bond theory and CFT, crystal field theory. So what is the limitation of valence bond theory? First topic, limitation of valence bond theory. Limitation of valence bond theory. Let's see, it is to be seen from the mobile. Please, 1 second. No, it is not seen. I have to write down part, not from here. It is not seen. Limitation of valence bond theory. Let's see, it is seen. Still not seen. Okay. Yes, now it is to be seen. So today we are going to discuss about the first topic, valence bond theory. So what is the limitation of valence bond theory? Generally, valence bond theory is applied in coordination compound or complex compound to predict the magnetic nature and structure of complex compound. Main two prediction is done by this theory, but there is some limitation that cannot be predicted by valence bond theory. What are the limitations? Let's discuss. I have one formula. With the help of that formula, you can easily remember all the points of limitation of valence bond theory. Just I am writing that CA, IQ, MIC, IQ, TKS, 4WSL. This is the formula by which we can easily remember all the points. CAIQMI. CAIQMIC. IQTKS. 4WSL. You just revise these points, this slogan, and you can easily remember all the points of limitations of valence bond theory. First is CA means what? So valence bond theory consists of some assumption. First topic, first point, valence bond theory consists some assumption. CA consists some assumption. Second, it cannot interpret qualitative magnetic information. It cannot interpret qualitative magnetic information. It cannot predict qualitative magnetic information. C, it cannot predict the color. Complex compound having different color, but valence bond theory cannot predict the color of complex compound. So C means color. it cannot interpret qualitative thermodynamics and kinetic stability. It cannot interpret qualitative thermodynamics and kinetic stability. Thermodynamics, kinetic stability. It cannot interpret qualitative is common. And four coordination number having two different shape. If ligand are four or coordination number of four of complex compound, there are two different shape, square planar shape and tetrahedral shape. Why these two type of shape is obtained in four coordination containing complex compound cannot predicted by valence bond theory. And last, it cannot make difference between strong and weak ligand. It cannot make difference between strong and weak ligand or weak and strong ligand. So all limitations of valence bond theory with the help of this simple formula we have discussed. I am repeating again, generally valence bond theory is applied for the magnetic property of complex compound and structure of complex compound, but it has some limitations. Which are the limitations of valence bond theory? The limitations are to be explained by simple formula. CA means it consists of some assumptions. It cannot interpret the qualitative magnetic information. It cannot interpret the qualitative magnetic information. MI means magnetic information. It cannot predict the color of complex compound. Why complex compound having different color? It is not predicted by valence bond theory. It cannot interpret the qualitative thermodynamics and kinetic stability. T means thermodynamics, K means kinetic, and S means stability. Coordination number 4 having two different shape. It may be tetrahedral, it may be square planar of complex compound. Why it is to be done in complex compound? Why two different shapes are available in complex compound? Cannot be predicted by valence bond theory. And it cannot make difference between why ligand is strong and why ligand is weak. So it is cleared now. Ready? Now second topic we are going to discuss, that is crystal field theory. Very most important for the board. It is generally asked in 4 marks and very easy, very simple. You can easily remember. Try to concentrate on my video lecture. So we are going to discuss another topic, that is the crystal field theory. Very most important crystal field theory. Crystal field theory. CFT. Just again showing that it is to be seen in board clearly. Let's see, please. Yes, it is clear. So what is crystal field theory? So crystal field theory is electrostatic model. It is electrostatic model. First topic, it is electrostatic model. Crystal field theory is electrostatic model. It is generally known as electrostatic model. First word is important. There is some different discussion is done in crystal field theory. We have generally discussed that the coordination compound is formed, then metal and ligand having coordination bond. In generally complex compound, we have discussed in all earlier topic. Now here is kahani mein twist. The word is kahani mein twist. What is the twist in crystal field theory or according to crystal field theory? According to crystal field theory, metal and ligand having ionic bond. Generally, ionic bond is formed between the outside the square bracket ion and metal. That is the primary valency, and ligand and metal form is secondary valency. Here only we are discussing related to ligand is formed with metal ionic bond. That is the kahani mein twist. What happened? So we are going to discuss all remaining theory with the help of particular figure. Let's see.